What's going on, guys? This is Silent Mike here at Super Training Gym. I'm with world record holding Chris Duffin, and he's here. He's gonna teach me how to squat. We're gonna start with some warm-ups, I think.
We are. But he thinks we're just gonna talk about squat, and we're gonna talk about how to make him move better and operate better as a whole. So the squat is the most beautiful movement in our sport. Because it's how we can actually fix a lot of things. A lot of things that go with, like, the sedentary individuals that walk into the gym or people that have issues on a daily basis. How do you fix it? How do you make them better? You teach them to squat.
Got to take a shit. Got to pick up the kids from the ground. It's all so natural.
It is. So we're going to walk through a couple things first, because these are going to feed right into the cueing that we're going to do on how we squat. But at first, you're going to seem a little odd, because we're going to talk about breathing, we're going to talk about bracing, and then we're actually going to work on power transfer through the hip to the shoulder.
Cool.
So we're actually going to set this aside, because that's going to get to the shoulder piece, and I need you to do the other stuff first.
Gotcha.
Correct first. So we're going to take a deep breath.
Like a lifting breath? Now I'm scared.
I'm not going to punch you yet. All right. So do that again. Put your hands up here on your collarbone. All right. You're doing a little bit better now. So we want to make sure, first thing is that we're trying to breathe what's called horizontally, this direction. We want to expand outward and not vertically upwards. So a lot of us, if we're sitting at a desk or stress in life or Facebooking or whatever, we start breathing up here, okay? This is a bad thing. So we want to make sure that we're practicing belly breathing. And a good thing to think about is, like, this is all an open pitcher. And if water's gonna come in, it's gonna fill from the bottom up. So as you breathe, it should be a wave that moves up and down, up and down. So breathe in here. And we shouldn't, I hadn't put his hands up here because his first breath, his clavicle rose. And it's a good feedback right here, is to do that. So we wanna work on expanding outwards here. And even into the base of the rib cage is gonna expand outwards, but we don't wanna see upward movement on this chest here. So that's something that you definitely want to make sure that you're correct and you're practicing on a regular basis if you've got issues. And most of us do have issues.
Yeah.
So let's take that breath in here. Good. So we're pushing out in here. Good. So next, I'm gonna teach you a couple breathing drills that are really going to learn you positioning. So this isn't what you're going to do before you squat.
This is not. Gotcha.
But it's going to teach you good position.
Yeah, how to get tight.
Because if I talk about it without doing it in this method, especially on a video, people are going to do it wrong. And this actually really helps you see and feel it.
Cool.
And then we'll actually go to how you actually hold and set that up. So what we need to do is take out every last breath of air you've got. Keep pushing it out through your teeth. More, everything, every last little bit. And you feel this rib cage pulling down.
Yeah, it hurts.
It's actually drawing down and pulling to the back. So what we're not trying to push the rib cage down, we're actually trying to draw it down. And so that method, do it again, everything out. Oh look, and you're very tight and rigid. So it's not, don't let it come back in. So I just want, every last bit, okay,
so
all of it.
It's not very natural.
No, it's not. So every last, quit sucking air in. I want you just out. So there's nothing left. Okay, and you feel how this is drawn down and how tight and rigid all this is? Okay.
Not bad, huh?
Yes.
Yeah.
So now what we're going to do is we want to get that same rib cage position. So all that is just to cue you to feel what this drawn down rib cage is, which is actually, that's that diaphragm actually pushing down. But instead of explaining how the diaphragm operates and all the intricacies there, this actually helps you just be able to practice and do it.
Okay? That kind of goes into kind of having a neutral spine. Yeah, a lot of times people will talk about like, look up, arch up. And you see like beginning squatters or a lot of like just trainers that just read here and there and don't go in depth, and people are squatting like this. Like, that's not very strong, we're trying to avoid all this.
It is not at all. And I'll show you why here in a second.
All right.
We're achieving a neutral spine, but it's not just having a neutral spine. So if you're relaxed and in neutral, you can get killed, okay? So we want to create as much rigidity between here and here as possible. And so we need a very tight, centrated core.
To grab that spine.
Now, if it's not neutral, you can't actually achieve that. And there's a reason. It's called an open scissor. So anytime that the diaphragm is not able to work basically in direct opposition to the pelvic floor here, this is what's called an open scissor. You can't achieve optimal bracing.
Yeah.
That's just a fact.
Yeah. Okay? Just out of position.
Yeah. So now I want you to get in that same ribcage position, but this time you're actually gonna breathe into it once you've got it. So keep this tightness, and now go ahead and breathe out into here. See, and now you've still got this good position here. Now you've got here, here. And next step is we wanna actually make sure these obliques are inflated. So relax them, good, and push out. If you can't see, my fingers are moving in and out when he does that, so relax again, and out, good. And so I'll do the same thing here. So I'll drive my fingers right into my sides here and my obliques.
Yeah. Yeah, well, it feels good.
You see how much that moves?
Yeah.
Yeah. So this, we want that. Okay. So good. So this is how we've got good bracing in our core now. So we've got good breathing, we've got good bracing in here. The bar is up here on our shoulder. So we're actually gonna cue deep spinal stabilization all the way up into there. So we've got good spinal stabilization here. So what we're gonna do here is, I'm gonna turn you towards the camera a little bit. We wanna pinch this spot right back here in the back. So you can pinch my finger, but fix this. There you go, huh? Okay. Or, because we're squatting,
yeah,
we're actually gonna just pull my hand in. Boom, lat pull down. Boom, this. A lot of people don't realize the lat is actually a spinal stabilizer.
It's long, yeah, it's a real long
it's
muscle.
It's long, and it connects to the shoulder and ties that into the spine as well. So this is how we get rigidity all the way in there, okay? So, I'm gonna get back here. So, you don't have to actually be to stand here, you can just do the pinch like that, just engage. So you don't actually have to open or do any of this, we just wanna fire the lats, we just wanna engage them. So here, I'm standing relaxed, I'm engaged, okay? And this is more of like what would happen in a deadlift. Boom. So you're not going into a big forward traction and actually making the lift longer than what it needs to be. So I want you to brace and breathe in. Good, good. And engage those lats. Good. All right. Now I want you to pinch a penny with your cheeks and twist the floor apart.
Which cheeks?
Your butt cheeks. So you can also think about it as prison defense or Mark Smelly Bell defense, right? Yeah. He's sneaking up behind you. What are you going to do?
That's the only thing we're good at. Yeah, super training.
So do that. Jump, jump. Good. And neutral with the head. Okay. And go ahead and you can still breathe into this. You can still breathe. Belly breathe into this. Hold this position. This is what I call standing strong. You've got to be able to stand before you can squat. It's very important. Okay, imagine a big, giant weight coming out of the sky, hitting you on the shoulders right now. So stand strong. You feel ready for it, dropping on those shoulders?
Yeah.
Okay, let's keep it into the squat pattern that you were just showing me, like how everybody's taught to squat.
Yeah.
Right here, get here like this, okay?
Right.
All right, get in there. What's gonna happen when that weight hits your shoulders now?
Just,
it's gonna come right the fuck through you.
Yeah.
And you can just feel it, can't you?
Yeah. Belt's not helping. Like, there's no way to get tight.
Exactly. So, under remedial load, so anything like under 95%, you're not really gonna see necessarily that. You're still gonna be in good position. Yeah. You think you're doing great. But once you get towards that, like, you know, you're doing a set of five to failure, rep number four is great. Number five, or that maximal load, this is when the breakdown occurs. This is when this stuff becomes very, very critical.
Yeah.
So we want to practice this on all our warm-ups. Okay. So that shoulder position, that lat engagement, is very important. So go ahead and pull in again. See that? Your rib cage is coming out again. Right. And now your elbow went back. So elbow mobility plays a big role in this. And you notice I've got his arm out here. So in here, like a lot of, you know, you see a lot of people come in really, really tight, but try to engage the lat now.
Yeah.
It's not as, you may be really tight right in here. So it feels great. You've got this nice tight shelf.
Yeah.
So I'm not saying wider's better. I'm definitely saying as close as possible isn't better, right? Because you're losing the lat engagement, but out here you're losing some of this tightness.
Yeah.
So we want to be wide enough that we can actually cue the lat. So arm position is only critical in the fact that allows us to be able to do lat engagement. So you have to actually be doing the work to gain the benefit of it. So what we want to do is we want to be as close as possible, but to where we can still bend the bar over our back.
What's your
so if we get in here, you're not going to be able to do that.
Yeah.
What's you've got tightness here, which you can see, like with a lot of Olympic style squatters. Watch them when they get to their failure point.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah.
That real tightness here,
shaking,
but then it starts going to here, because that tightness is not tied to here. So that's what we're going to do.
What about elbow positioning? You see a lot of guys maybe elbow flared, maybe their backs aren't big enough to hold the bar, or some people are taught push your elbows under really tight. I think you can kind of get a tight lat position either way, but what's your thoughts?
So we don't want to be driving forward. So we definitely don't want to be in this position. That's why I said as tight as possible where you can still pull the bar down. So that may be, like especially for a big lifter, way out there, because as soon as they come in, they're starting to do this. Right? And that's why we're going to do a little bit of warm-up work here. So what I'm going to do, this is RNT, so reactive neuromuscular training. A lot of, like what you would do with, if you got a new lifter that's struggling with, like opening the knees up, you put a band or a hip circle around, right? And all of a sudden, boom, we cue in glute engagement. So actually adding resistance actually cues the muscles to fire. So we're going to do that. We're going to do an overhead squat. So basically, we're going to go hands up overhead, elbows locked out.
Yeah.
And we're going to think about rib cage position, and we're going to squat.
Okay.
So I'm going to cue you because you're going to kind of drift on these.
Yeah,
it's
sure.
going to be pretty hard. But at the end, we should see a really good improvement in
what angle you need, Moneymaker? What angle you need? This fine face of the mono?
So up overhead, good. Lock out the elbows, good. Now, rib cage, brace. We're going to practice. We want to go ahead and practice everything that we're doing. So inflate those obliques. Now go ahead and squat. And good. Come up. Let's do 20 reps. And as you go, pull it back, rib cage in, brace, up, pull it back, arms up more overhead, squat, and keep going. I'm just going to keep cueing you. Pull it back again, rib cage in, brace. Pull it back. Arms up more overhead. Whew. Yeah. Hey, you're sweating, man. Good. Six. Pull it back. Arms up a little bit more overhead. All right. How many reps are you on?
I don't know.
Okay.
20.
Do five more. There we go. Real fast. Do them right. Good. Good. All right. So now, let's move to squatting.
Yeah.
So first, let's think about the cues that we just did, right? So we braced, so we draw down, we inflate, we engage the lats, and then the last thing that we do, we talked about pinching a penny, but here we're just going to think about twisting the floor apart as we sit back. Boom. So that's our cues.
Yeah.
That's it.
And then the rest just kind of happens.
So we're going to draw down.
Yeah.
I want you to listen to me on all these as we do this. So we're going to draw down. We're going to inflate. Bend the bar over our back. Twist the floor apart and sit back.
Okay.
That's it.
Sounds easy enough.
That is. So you know, we actually skipped a whole lot. We're not worried about knee position, all this other stuff.
Yeah.
Because if we do all this right here in the center, all the peripheral stuff is going to come into play.
Yeah, yeah.
So I've got a lot of experience coaching this with some of the best athletes in the world, but also just people that walk into the gym that have never squatted before, and within 15, 20 minutes, you can have them squatting better than people that have been squatting for, on the platform for years. Because we're not worried about what the peripheral is doing. We're going to control it.
Yeah, okay? Makes sense.
Okay.
Big brace on the unrack. What's your breathing compared to an unrack and then to begin the squat?
So I will brace before I pop up, but before I squat again, I will make sure that I draw down.
Yeah, a couple inflate. More breaths.
So, because you're not going to be able to get this optimal position, so we're going to work on getting the stand strong first.
Yeah.
Because when you unrack,
something
you've got an opportunity to lock this in a little bit better once you're actually fully standing.
Yeah.
How's that bar position, shoulder position feel after that little
warm-up? It's actually pretty good.
Okay. Usually that's something if we test and retest, you'll see like an immediate. It doesn't feel like you did anything there.
Yeah, but my traps and
but you
really
the bar and you're like,
warm.
Oh my God, I can actually get in the best position.
Yeah, I can get way lower if I wanted to. I couldn't do this a second ago.
Yes.
Yeah.
Good. Okay. So, draw down, inflate, bend the bar, twist the floor apart, sit back. Okay. I'd like you to get in a little bit more neutral head pusher. So push this back into the bar. And we're gonna look at that point in the wall right there where the floor meets the wall, and keep that inner horizon. Good. There you go. A little bit more stand strong at the top. So there you go. Pull all the way through. Okay. Okay, let's rack it. Let's put some weight on.
Yeah, feels good. Do the bumpers make me look strong?
Okay. And I'll just let you warm up here as well.
What's kind of your rep scheme on warm-ups? Say we're working, like for me example, I'll work with 450 today. You kind of take plate for a bunch, two plates for a bunch, and then go into singles. You kind of keep your rep scheme all the way up.
So usually I'll do a fairly extensive warm-up beforehand, what we did for our deadlift workout yesterday.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
If you watch the video of the deadlift where we did rear leg elevated split squats, goblet squats, hip airplanes, the hip side shift, right? That'll be a really good warm up. So when I get to this, I'm actually trying to keep my reps fairly minimal until I work up.
Conserve some energy.
Yep. So I may hit five reps with a plate, and then after that I may be just doubles or triples all the way up, whatever jumps. And that jumps are going to vary by strength, right?
And then what about wraps? You train with wraps almost every session. When do you start wrapping?
I usually start wrapping around like 500-600 pounds.
Okay, say I'm working to 450. Should I start wrapping around 380?
Yeah,
something like that.
Yep. And jumps are going to be anywhere, from 70-pound jumps, maybe 50s for a lighter lifter. I usually do 110-pound jumps because I'm using the kilo plates and I've got a lot of weights to
roll
up. And
that's relative to what you're lifting.
So practice those cues, and I'm going to repeat them to you. Stand strong. So draw down, inflate, bend the bar, twist the floor, sit back. Boom. Okay. Let's re-rack the bar a little bit. I think we're going to have you move your feet out a little bit. So when we talk about twisting the floor, we're actually talking about rooting to the floor. So this is a little bit what we talked about yesterday. But you've got three points, so the heel here and here. So we've got this arch of our foot and the arch this way. And you basically think about it like an eagle claw. And you want to grab the ground and twist it up. Boom. So right now you're kind of rolling just a little bit because you're actually so close together. So
okay.
We're gonna move out just like an inch.
Yeah.
So nothing major, but I wanna be able to make sure that you can grab really good and be twisting, which is gonna cause those knees to sit in the position that
I just
we
know
want.
The rule is if you squat outside your shoulders, you're cheating. So I didn't wanna get too close.
Okay, well,
we're gonna cheat. Just for today. Do it again.
Let's add weight.
Oh. Yeah, I was lifting in heels for a while with a pretty narrow stance, even narrower than this. It felt okay, but under heavier loads, I'd just get pitched forward really hard, and I'd also squat like just deep, and I couldn't control it. You know, I'd get a good rebound out of there, but I was squatting a foot under depth. So I was like, well, if I go to flats, widen it out, still try to get that same rebound, but maybe conserve some something, strength somewhere.
I think with this proper bracing, you'll see a lot more strength in the hole.
Yeah.
So, and maybe we'll play around with a couple things after we work up.
Yeah.
Cool. But I show you how to develop that a little bit further. Let me know if you want me to run the rack on any of these.
Yeah, maybe after this one.
Okay.
Yeah.
Good. There you go, right there. Okay. Draw down, inflate, bend the bar over your back. Good. Good. How's that feel?
Yeah, not bad.
How's it feel compared to normal?
Feels strong.
Good.
My low back's been a little tweaked, so I feel it, but.
We also pulled heavy yesterday, didn't we?
Yeah. That didn't help. Another plate.
So that's one thing I want you to think about, given that we just pulled yesterday and some more bracing stuff, is also to imagine is you're inflating here, is to push that air all the way out through your back.
Yeah.
Even though you don't have a belt on, imagine there's a belt and you're actually pushing and inflating. So try that right now. Here, do you feel that push out against my hand?
Yeah.
Good, I want to see that all the way. That's gonna help take that a little bit.
I was actually gonna add a belt. Is that
good time? Good time.
I don't even know where it went. Right in front of robot's face.
So going forward, you're gonna think about what's my optimal bracing, and that adding extra tightness on the belt isn't gonna necessarily make it better.
Yeah.
So you may actually get to a point where you're too sucked in.
Yeah, you can't push out.
Brace properly.
Yeah.
So.
Makes sense. We'll just do one rep then?
Yep.
Yeah.
I'm trying to figure out how to work this thing.
Okay. Yeah, it'll go backwards a little bit.
All right, draw down, inflate, bend the bar, twist the floor apart. Boom.
Yeah, it feels pretty good.
Good.
Yeah.
You want to rest a minute?
Yeah, I'll take 1 second.
Lower the rack height.
Is it? Yeah.
Okay, good. All right, and open. And as you're doing that, you're pulling the knee away, and then close, and you're pushing that way, okay? Yeah, you're here, and then there, good. And then there, you can pull the knee away as you open, you should feel it right through here. And then in, out, and I'm gonna push in. I do a lot of grabbing people and push them this way because usually as powerlifters we're pretty thick and actually just closing that hip can be difficult on your own.
Yeah.
Good, and let's hit the other side.
Ooh, hurts so bad.
Good, you're getting this down pretty good. Yeah, I'll bet you next week you won't need anything to hold on to do this. So as you're coming up, you don't need to raise the leg, you're rotating at the hip. There you go, so it's, there you go. Feel that?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. Again. Good. Wait for the cues. I want you to make sure you stand strong before you squat.
Actually,
okay?
Squat.
Tell your body what you're gonna do. I'm ready. Okay. Well, good. Right. Draw it down. Inflate, bend the bar, good. Twist the floor apart and sit back.
Okay. Felt pretty good.
Okay.
Felt a little slow, but.
So Mike here is doing the cat camel. So you notice he's basically rotating the pelvis anteriorly and posteriorly. It's all down in here. So we've got, this position is basically staying the same, but moving between a camel or scared cat position and camel. So back and forth here, okay? And what we're doing is basically this is just some hydraulic action on the annulus of the disc. So anyone that's got basically disc issues, this is a very good movement, especially in the morning. Pump that. Anyone that has disc issues in the morning, basically the fluids around the in the annulus kind of move out into the tissue around it. So there's less fluid in there and they usually have some more pain, and that slowness and getting out of bed in the morning can be difficult. So this is a good movement. We also mix this a lot of times with the McKenzie press up. So let's go ahead and show that one as well. So there we go. We've got the hips into the ground. This is basically a really bad looking push up. Both of these movements, I like lifters to do them fairly fast because it's a pumping action. So we're basically pumping fluid from the front to the back of the disc. So if you're lifting with some issues, this can be very effective, especially right before lifting, to get yourself feeling better. And if you combine this with basically the bracing strategies that we went through on the squat, that's what's going to be spinal protective and allow you to basically add load without doing further damage. So this is more of your rehab, prehab type stuff, and then actually working forward and adding load is the things that we went through on the squat here, and those transfer across all the lifts. So the cueing that we went through is going to be the same stuff there.
Yeah, for the deadlift and yeah. Overhead press or anything.
Exactly. So I always wrap my knees myself.
Yeah.
I'm going to do it just so I can show you here. But I always go outwards on each one just to make sure we're controlling that kneecap position well and not. And also, it just seems like there can be a little bit of tendency to pull the knee one way or the other with the how you put the tension in there. So start just below, basically a full knee wrap below the knee. So hold this right here. First one, we'll just lock in. Okay. And then from there, we're going to go basically about a half a wrap up on each one. And
see a lot of people use like chalk and stuff. Do you any water or any tricks?
I'll chalk before a huge,
chalk your knee, chalk your hands.
I'll chalk just to lock it on the knee some more. Keep your knee locked out there. Good. And pull this toe up there. That's going to create some more tension when you release and the calf goes back up in there. And you can do a little bit of crisscross as you go up, but it doesn't really add that much. But if I do that, I'm always trying to put as much material behind the knee as possible. So we're gonna go up.
Basically just going halfway up each wrap.
Yep, and then once I get to the top here, we're gonna actually go, we're gonna lock this in. So we're gonna come over the whole wrap and then lock it down on the bottom. So one full rotation on the bottom. Now we're gonna go cross it back up this way, across the top, and I'm gonna lock it in again. Okay, boom. Now, I'm gonna grab my handy dandy pliers here and go ahead and thread this through right there.
Underneath?
Yep, just right here, it's good.
Oh, my fat, pale skin.
So you can actually roll it in there in advance, or if you miss it, this is handy there, open it up. I'm gonna feed the very end here, so go ahead and close that.
I'm pinching my fat in it. There we go, and pull through?
And pull through. Boom. Just like that.
That's so tight.
All right, let's see that other one.
Ow. I don't know, I'm not even gonna be able to hit depth with this weight.
We didn't roll it very tight.
I'm right. Such a wimp.
Okay, take your hand out. So half a wrap. Keep that leg locked, good. Gonna get about full wrap above the knee. And we're gonna crisscross.
Jump.
Locking the bottom.
Crisscross, no one.
And back up. And lock the top. This time, actually, let's put it in advance.
Oh,
under in advance.
Gotcha.
Okay. Opened it up again. I didn't get it all the way. Yeah, you probably
got it.
We got it. There we go.
This will be tough. Nope. Oh.
All right. Remember what you're gonna do. Unrack that weight. Draw it down. Inflate. Bend the bar over your back. Twist the floor apart and sit back. Good. Turn that floor good. Okay. All right. Stand strong. Draw it down. Inflate. Bend the bar. Sit. Twist the floor apart. Sit back.
So much rap.
That looked pretty easy.
Yeah, it was way too easy. Way too much rap going on.
Yeah. down there. Okay. In your head, man. Five easy steps. Drop down. Wait, bend the bar. Sit back.
That's good.
Oh. I think the first one came up too fast on you. You lost the balance.
It wraps us. It feels so weird from not rapping for forever.
Oh, yeah.
One of the first things I noticed is, as soon as I thought of those five steps as you're screaming at me, the squat did kind of take care of itself, especially with the lighter weight. I'm still getting used to wraps again, so things felt a little funky, but with 460 or whatever the set before, got tight. Held the bar tight, screwed my feet in, got in a tight stance, and then my hips just kind of started moving, you know, and that felt really efficient.
Yeah, and that's really what makes it. If you take those five simple steps, everything else just kind of takes care of itself.
Yeah.
And you know, that leads into the next step. So like with the tighter wrap, and that little bit extra support, and now with more spinal stability, what we can actually do is work on widening that stance a little bit more. And then you're going to be able to see even more being able to stay erect in that hole and that ability to sit between your legs. So like right here, and I was just showing this a minute ago, I'm going to move my knees just a little bit. And do you see how much change
everything
happens here?
Okay, your back looks a little weaker.
Here. I mean, this is huge difference, right? So you're going to be able to do that, and especially with that added, you know, you got some nice little rebound in those wraps, you're going to have a little bit more ability to stay in this position versus this position.
Right.
Which now you combine that with more stability here and more efficient power transfer, and you're going to be more upright and able to transfer more power into that bar.
Yeah, everyone talks about finding a good position or getting a good position or what good form is, but they don't necessarily explain step by step on how to do it. Once you can get into that position, obviously it's a lot easier to maintain it, and then you maintain it with heavier weights, and that's how you get stronger.
Yeah, and that's exactly. I mean, we've got to have good, clean movement, then we add progressive load.
Yeah.
But that's exactly, you know, that's a key point here is, if you go to a lot of elite lifters and like look at what they're doing this stuff.
Yeah.
But they don't necessarily know what it is they're doing,
yeah,
or how to coach it, or, you know, and that's really what I'm trying to do is take that down into a very easy thing to distill and be able to coach.
Yeah.
Anybody at any level very easily.
Yeah, it should transfer up and down, right?
Because
running's the same for a 6-year-old as an elite track star, one's just better at it. Lifting should be the same for a beginner and an advanced, just one has more muscle and strength over time.
So if we can take somebody that isn't necessarily have that athletic where they're automatically just doing that stuff, we can actually teach them how to do it, and then they can work forward and progress in that manner.
Awesome.
So
I think that's it, guys. Check out Chris. What's your website?
KabukiWarrior.com.
Supertraining.tv, and we're out.
If you like the content and you want to support the production of further content and also look like a badass, check out Whiskey and Deadlift shirts. You can buy them on my website, KabukiWarrior.com. Or if you actually want to move better and improve your strength and performance as a strength athlete, I also recommend that you check out the Shoulder Rock. Again, available on KabukiWarrior.com.